Hello everyone and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube. Welcome back to my UMass Dynasty in NCAA 13. This is the Offline Dynasty. We're into week 11 now. This is episode 8 as we crammed 3 games into one of the episodes. Looking at the head coaching contract details and how it's going. You can read all the details there. It is a 3-year contract, so keep that in mind. So as you look that over, got a couple housekeeping things to talk about. This episode will mark the return to Heisman level difficulty on the field. I'm not guaranteeing it'll stay that way, as I was actually quite pleased with the last 3 games on All-American level with slider changes, but we'll see how it goes. And Antoine Tharp is named Defensive Player of the Week in the MAC. Congratulations. Nice to see a UMass player up there. His 2 interceptions gets him up the board there. But hey, that's not the only thing I want to point out. Mr. Hurricane, are you watching? Eric Sosa, Offensive Player of the Week for the entire NCAA. Congrats to the Roadrunners and specifically to Eric Sosa for that accomplishment. Pretty cool. Go watch Mr. Hurricane's UTSA Dynasty if you haven't already. All right, ripping right on into our recruiting. You see the big board here, our needs. Well, we're rated D- to D+ in pretty much every category, so we have needs across the board. But you see the positions we absolutely have to fill. And we've got some bad news on the Cam Slinger front. I thought we had made really good ground up. Apparently not enough. Cam Slinger is now a hard commit to Michigan State. We gave him the hard sell, but in the end, Cam Slinger chooses to go with Sparty and not to UMass. Okay, well, he'll be missed, but we got to move on without him. Maybe we even schedule Michigan State on the schedule next year. What do you think? Show Mr. Slinger what he should have picked. Anyway, we're going to scout some others here. This Jim Mitchell might be a long shot as we're kind of catching up with him late in the game. But he is a junior college athlete, and he's a 74 overall. Well, not really scouted very much yet. Definitely somebody that could help us, so we'll get on his board and hope that maybe he has some interest in us. Also looking at James White, a center here that would be very nice for us to land. We're currently second on his board behind Washington. We don't really gain a whole lot in there. I would have liked to have done better, but some of these schools, we just don't match up well in pitches. When you find someone that we do, it really is nice. So here are the hard commits so far. Pretty good crowd considering who we are and who they are. We found a junior college tackle there who's a 74 overall. That's a big coup for us to get that one. So it's on to Akron to face the 2-8 Zips. We are 3-6 ourselves after winning 3 in a row. That big, exciting game in Northern Illinois, the comeback. It was huge for UMass. Huge. So there was a lot of mixed reaction in the comments on whether to stay at All-American with my sliders and continue tweaking or to jump back up to Heisman. So we're back up to Heisman. A couple tweaks in things that I saw were killing me in the first few weeks because I want this to be competitive. If I'm going to get blown up by 30 points every game, I'm not going to play every game like that. They got to at least be fun to play. So here we are back on Heisman, and we'll see how things go against Akron. They're 2-8. It might not be the best judge of what's going on, but we're going to see. So handing off to Alan Williams to start the game. He gets about 3 yards. 2nd and 7 now. Pagel settles under center and hands off to fullback Burns, who burrows forward for another few yards. It's 3rd and 4. Pagel's got to make a connection, and he does with Rob Blanchflower. There you go. The big tight end makes his first catch of the game. 1st and 10 now. Looking to hand off to Alan Williams again, who's going to cut through the gap and get 9 yards. 2nd and 1 now. Sending Blanchflower deep, and he beats the secondary. Can Pagel find him? Sure he can. All alone, Rob Blanchflower. Get off me. He's in the end zone. Tells the crowd to quiet right there. And it's a huge touchdown for Rob Blanchflower. Look at Kellen Pagel load up, fire deep, and Blanchflower makes the catch and gets in the end zone. How about that? 7-0 lead, UMass, and the defense on the sideline is pumped up. They're ready to go after it. They'll be in charge of slowing down another spread offense here. Moore in the shotgun, going to take it. Find Price at the sideline. He sheds a tackle and gets a first down. So Akron on the move. Oh, look at, they set up the screen just at the right time. Going to get first down yardage and a little bit more. So Akron moving the ball as well so far. 1st and 10 again. It's going to fake the handoff. Moore's going to take it himself. And by the time they catch him, he's got a first down. Akron has got it going now. The Zips, we'll see what they do here. They're setting the pace here with the no huddle action. And there's 9 more yards. 2nd and 1 now. Going to hand off to Chisholm. Going to the right. Puts his head down and gets first down yardage. 2nd and 9 now. And it's a handoff to Alexander, who's going to go up the middle for 6 yards. 3rd and 4. Can the defense get a stop? Yes. Okay. We brought pressure in the right gap, and we're going to hold them to a field goal attempt. So bend but don't break defense in full effect right there on the first drive. UMass leads 7-3 after Akron's first offensive drive. Back on offense. Oh, already 3rd and 12 when Kellen Pegel tries to draw the defense off. Instead, his own lineman jumps. Not good. So now it's 3rd and 17. Just trying to get any bit of that back. He's going to go for a pass to Danska, but it's going to be broken up. Danska and Michelle were both in that area. Broken up. So back to the Zips, and Chisholm out of the draw play is going to get a first down. They seem to be moving the ball just fine on most parts of the field. There, but there is a sack. Looked like they were setting up that screen again. This time they were wise to it. Got to him before they could set it up. But that pass to Pratt is not going to be stopped. That's a big play. And they get first down yardage again. So again, down to the red zone here. More to roll right. No, you don't. We brought the pressure in the right spot there. As you see McIntyre and Potvin, I believe. Yeah, Potvin's actually the one who gets their first and gets the sack. So 2nd and 18. Handing off to Rossi. No, we figured that one out too. As you see a replay here, it'll now be 3rd and 22. Nice. They ran right into where we were sending a blitz. So 3rd and 22, they go play action. He's got a lot of time to throw, and he's got his man, except Tharp is going to get in there, get a hand on the ball, and this will be incomplete. Would not have been first down yardage, but it's going to make for a more interesting field goal attempt here, as this is ripped out, incomplete. So 4th and 22, trying to make this a 7-6 ball game, and oh, he just misses. So it was a big play causing that incomplete pass. Akron gets nothing on this drive. And the fans, well, they've had kind of a frustrating season so far. 2-8, and just more things going wrong. Here is Williams running to the left-hand side for 7. 2nd and 3. Going to go to Cox, who's in the ball game. But that first down play might be brought back here. We'll check the flag. Yes, indeed, it is a holding against the Minutemen. And it's against our buddy Rob Blanchflower. Oh, well, we'll give him a gimme here after his touchdown catch. Pagel very quickly gets it out to Cox there on the screenplay, and he is able to get a first down. Nice play there. Kellen's got 3rd and 9. He's looking at here. He's going to throw. Nope, that's going to be broken up. So it goes back to Akron and their offense. Their defense has figured things out here recently. 3rd down and long, but he slides down before first down yardage, so they got to give the ball back up. Minute 27 left now. He's going to go for long. And he will make the catch. They are in no huddle territory here, trying to do the 2-minute drill. This pass will be to Dowling. Dowling's going to get a first down, hop forward. So still running up to the ball and move quickly. Long again is going to make a catch down to the 5-yard line. Just like that, the no huddle quick strike offense is working out pretty well. 1st and goal, hand off to Alan Williams. Nope, not going to get in. 2nd and goal, still from about the 5. Pagel. Looking to throw. He's going to roll with a little pressure. He gets hit, but he finds Danska in the back of the end zone. Chase Danska gets the touchdown. Let's look at it again. As you see, Kellen Pegel evade the rush just enough to find Danska. He throws the arm up. I'm open, and he hits him. Touchdown, Minutemen, and there is a 14-3 lead. 28 seconds left in the half. Moore wants to get something out of this. He'll hit his man over the middle for first down yardage. They will hurry up as well. 20 seconds now and ticking. Moore has time to throw. And will find Chisholm out of the backfield for another first down. Are they close enough for a field goal? Maybe not quite yet. 8 seconds left, though. Moore's got time. To the sideline. Great catch by Pratt. My goodness, look at this one again. What concentration with defenders around him. And to be able to bring this down, as you see the pass, he squares up, keeps the feet in. Absorbs that hit and still gets the foot down. Very nice catch. So with 4 seconds left, they've got the chance for the field goal. Good rush on it, but it's going to be good. So 14-6 is your halftime score. UMass with 2 touchdowns to Akron's 2 field goals. So Akron gets the ball first in the third quarter. Moore is going to find his man just in time there as the coverage comes over, but not early enough to knock it away. Chisholm's going to take the handoff and get a first down. The Zips' problem has not been moving the ball in the least today. It's been just getting it in the end zone. There's another first down. They go option, quarterback keeper. Third and seven now. What do they have here? Hand off to Chisholm, puts his head down, and doesn't get everything he needs. He's short. It's fourth and three. Another field goal attempt. We've held them after moving down the field in a crucial spot, not letting them get in the end zone. They will get the field goal, so it's 14-9. They're within one score. Pagel is going to throw to Hill. Nice little grab there with a man on him, but it's fourth and five, unfortunately. They punt the ball after not getting enough yardage. Moore going to keep it himself, but this time they put the spy on him, and that spy is Perry McIntyre. Not going to let him out of his grasp. So second and eight now. Moore to throw. Nope, that one was fairly hotly contested, and it's knocked down or dropped, one or the other. So back to UMass's offense. Third and ten. Blanchflower makes a great catch, and he's got yardage. He split the defenders right there. Ooh, a tricky little pass by Kellen Pagel, but he navigates and gets it right in there for Blanchflower. Look at this. There's a nice little bullet, and Blanchflower throws the arms out there, sticks it, and finds he's got a few yards after the catch as well. There you go, Rob. Nice play. Had a big game so far. So we're into the fourth quarter now officially. Allen Williams full steam ahead for 8 yards. Second and two. We're trying to maybe send Blanchflower deep again. Yes, sir. Right down the middle. Makes the catch. He's inside the 5 yard line. Pagel to Blanchflower has been a great connection all day long. Hand off to Burns, the fullback. Going to get to about the 2 yard line. So second and goal. What do they call? They scored once on a quick pass. This time it's a handoff to Allen Williams. He just cuts to that opposite gap there where no resistance is found. Touchdown Allen Williams and touchdown UMass Minutemen. So 21-9 now, 3 minutes and change left. Chisholm's going to get a good run here. Wow, we just cannot seem to stop those draw plays. We're more concerned about getting beat deep, especially with the score the way it is now. There's a nice pass to Dunn, going to make the catch and absorb the blow there. First down. This turns into second and 10. Again, handing off to Chisholm. Yep, sir. That's another first down run. They seem to get it consistently when they run that. First and 10. More throwing to Chisholm on the screen. And again, the screen set up. Perry McIntyre will put an end to this play, but not before they get first down yardage. And we're about 2.5 minutes left when Moore tucks it again. And this time he's got first down. Okay, they're knocking on the door again. What can we do? Can we thwart him one more time? That's to the end zone, and oh, he had hands on it, but he couldn't hang on. Third and 10 now. Let's see what we can dial up on D. Oh, he's in his face, and ah, looked like another screen attempt that was not able to get off there. That's a very nice play by the D line to get to him fast enough to not let him make the play. So, fourth and 22 now. They are gonna have to go for it. Moore has a little bit of pressure but steps away from it. End zone knocked away. I think it was Burt who made the play. So trying to kill this clock, and all the timeouts are gone for Akron, but Pagel falls forward. Not enough. We got a punt because they were short and fourth and inches. Here they come one more time. Can we keep them out of the end zone one more time? This defense has been huge when it comes to the red zone or down near their goal line. So far, they've kept him out, only allowing the 3 field goals. That's the difference in the game. 3 UMass touchdowns to 3 Akron field goals. 3 scores apiece. But ours were the touchdown variety, and that puts us up 21-9. Here they bring the house. Here comes a screen. Very nicely played again. Chisholm almost gets himself into the end zone, spinning and falling down to about the 5-yard line. Third and goal. 3 seconds left. I don't think they have a play in their playbook that's going to get them enough points, but the pass to Price is short of the end zone. We've done it. We've kept them out of the end zone all day long, and we've won our 4 straight on Heisman difficulty, folks. Yes, I know those of you that were crying about the All-American difficulty. There it is on Heisman for you. Yeah, it's against a 2-8 team. And do I expect to run the rest of the table? Probably not, but this is a great story, a great winning streak. Kellen Pagel, your player of the game, not going to apologize for a win at any point. This one, not a cheapie. We take out a team we should beat, really, by their record. And we get it done. So we're now 4-6 after starting 0-6. Things are starting to develop. Can we make a run to a bowl game? I don't know. We've got Buffalo next. They're not so great either. We'll see how things go. Keep it going, Minutemen. We'll see you next time.